Hi, I will tell you about complete transformation from offline to online. This case shows you how we've been able to manage 100 million euro online revenue after third quarter of the last year. But before we start talking about this specific case, I must say that B2B is the hottest e-commerce field right now. Nearly 75% of B2B buyers say buying from an e-commerce site is more convenient than buying from a sales rep. Nearly 75% of buyers say that because even in a medium company, it's hard to teach every sales rep about all the product nuances. So it's common that customers know more about a specific product group than a sales reps. And this, of course, creates irritation on both sides. So there is no surprise that 30% of today's B2B buyers finalize at half of their purchases online, and this will nearly double to 56% by 2017. And in general, it's a good idea to give your customer additional channels of sales. Because 60% of B2B buyers say that they are open to spend more when interacting with multiple channels. And this omni-channel B2B customers are also more likely to become repeat and long-term customer. So if you are already in B2B or only about to start a B2B activity, this is the best time to embrace the e-commerce opportunity. So let's get back to our case study. Client of ours, Tim, is the biggest electrotechnical goods distributor in Poland and one of the biggest in the region. They have 30 years of experience in the market, and it's been on Warsaw Stock Exchange since 1998. Team serves clients from the construction business area. The goal of the project was diversification of business and improvement of effectiveness. That means we must expand their customer base and we must expand their product range, adding new product categories. We started our cooperation in 2011. First, we created a niche web shop with cables for B2C clients, and doing so, we were looking for the answers to two questions. First, can Tim sell online in the meaning of offer, logistic, and customer support? And second, can we acquire new customer groups? After two yeses, we were sure that we are ready to start the B2B project. So we start from gathering business requirements, and then we go to research phase. We conduct a user's research, for example, field research. And in the picture, you can see Kasia in one of our end clients' facilities. During that specific field research, we learned that sales reps prefer to call their call center and place orders directly to the operator rather than use a mobile phone, mobile app, for example. In this case, we've also completed B2C project previously I've just discussed, so we have some interesting data about new type of customers too. Then, based on these researches, we created a personas. Persona is a fictional identity that reflects one of the user groups we designed for. And persona helps you to understand what clients actually need. And usually we create 3 to 4 personas for each project. So here you can see persona of Henry. Henry is a 47-year-old technician with his own team. We've written things that Henry sees, feels, what his problems are, and how a company like a team can help him. And, you know, having this kind of persona gives customer data human face. Personas helps you prevent some common design pitfalls like overcomplicating, because if you think about new function, you can just ask yourself, is it usable for Henry? Will he use it, or maybe it's too complicated? And after personas, we start design phase. Our design phase is well documented. We use mockups as interactive prototypes, and we try to get clients involved in almost every phase of the design. So here you can see pictures from a workshop with team. We work in teams, we generate ideas using personas, we do paper prototyping. After each team presents a mockup and discuss the mockup with other teams. So it is for open discussion, and then we can choose the best ideas from the mockups. So here you can see three concepts of mockups. Each team prepared one concept. Then we prepare digital prototype. This digital version of prototype allow us to conduct user testing. And in this case, designing was a challenge because the potential customers either had an experience with online stores, buying on eBay or Amazon extensively, or had no experience whatsoever. So we had to find a common ground. And doing iterative testing, it was much easier. After each phase of tests, we did some tweaks, then we retest everything again. And this brings us to final digital mockups. Here you can see final digital mockup of one of the pages. I marked elements that were changed after the user tests. Then we go to graphic design phase, of course, and it took us about a month to finish the graphic work. To shorten the time to market, in the meantime, we carry on implementation. So, talking about implementation, we've been operating since 2008, so we've tried many e-commerce platforms. And today, Magento is usually the best choice because Magento is currently the most popular e-commerce software, is also the most popular platform to migrate to. There's a very flexible licensing model. You can use open source and you can use enterprise. And on the top of this, the software provides you a rich set of ready-to-use features. And now you can have Magento 2.0, which is growing audience really fast. Magento is great, but it's primarily designed for B2C. So you should consider these points when thinking about Magento as a B2B platform. And as you can see, I address all these issues by software, and mostly this is an open source software. So here you can see omnichannel open architecture. And as you can see, you could build quite complex systems based on open source modules. So if you are interested specifically in this, you can download this this infographic from devante.co/blog. It's on our blog. The hardest problems in e-commerce development are integration, especially creating failbacks. So if one of the system is down, you must be able to operate still. We use dedicated software as a buffer layer here to be sure that the system is working all the time. And one of the most powerful integration is CRM live integration. So just imagine you are a team customer, you just added some cables to your cart, and recommendation engine has analyzed your shopping cart, and it occurs that the clients who bought this type of cables bought also some specific stuff to connect these cables. So while you are still browsing, the team consultant calls you and offers you help. In B2B, this kind of advising your customer is very important to build strong relation, is very natural. So since you are interested in this this cables and in this special specific stuff to connect these cables, you are more than happy to accept the offer consultant gives you, and this consultant just add this stuff to your cart remotely. So thanks to bilateral integration in real time with the CRM, the merchants in Team Central can edit shopping carts of the customers that are currently logged on. So if you have any problems, you can just discuss it with a consultant, and he could modify your shopping cart where you are still browsing. And this kind of user stories are great inspiration for B2B system. So one day a consultant finds an order for 100 light bulbs and a huge electric pole, just like in the picture. And to ship such a pole, you have to carefully arrange the delivery, because it's extremely hard to deliver. So the consultant calls the client and find out that client doesn't need this huge electric pole, isn't interested in this at all, but he uses it as a bait. He wants to, consultant calls him so he can negotiate the price of the light bulbs. So, customers are clever, they, especially in B2B, they are looking for good deals. So that's how we realize we need this function of converting shopping cart to an offer inquiry to digital this process of negotiation. And of course there's lots of other dedicated functions here. One of interesting ones is dynamic offering. So team has a warehouse and there's lots of already cut cable slices in this warehouse, and they are really eager to sell this already cut pieces. So imagine you want to buy 2 kilometers of cable, and as it so happens, it occurs that team has 2.5 long piece in the stock, and they would love to get rid of it. So they offer you their 2.5 kilometer cheaper than your original 2 kilometer, and it's of course it's up to you to decide which length you will opt for, but this tool just broadens your choice. And again, you have this feeling that we are making deals together, we negotiate, we are doing business here. So this mechanism is great for the customer, but also improve business effectiveness of the team. So as you can see, there's lots of B2B functions here, and you may be thinking about what functions you should choose. There's so many functions. So I prepared this list of most common B2B functions in our project. So you have functions like list of contractors, ordering true files, offer creation. And in the cases like this one, all these dedicated functions should be implemented as an extra Magento modules. So you are still able to update your Magento, and this is crucial from the safety reasons. So this implementation phase took us 14 months, and after this phase we smoothly moved to development phase. And in the next few slides I will tell you what's the most important things in this development phase are. First is, of course, scalability and performance, because as the number of users were growing, you need to show extra care of the system performance. You need to be sure that your performance is still great. So we must tweak Magento, and here is a basic list of things you should think about, like replication of the database, using a cache system, using a HTTP reverse proxy, using a specialized database. And there is also an issue with ensuring quality, because here, especially in e-commerce B2B, the extra risk factor is a big number of integration. So we prepare tools which help us to maintain this high quality, starting from two-phase code review, where developers are cross-checking their code through the version control to monitoring systems. And I remember one day when we overpassed 250,000 euro daily revenue, and we realized that, you know, every downtime of the system will be huge measurable loss. So we know we must be able to react under 1 hour to prepare workaround for any problem. So we started Devante SWAT. It's a special form unit working 24/7, and the membership is optional, but to sign up, every member has to pass an official exam. And after this, members get special bonuses added to their monthly salary, but the group responsibility is applied here, just like in army. If SLA is violated on any website, nobody gets their bonuses. And because of this system, we are able to achieve SLA higher than 99.9%. And the next issue is to maintain effective development. So we establish dedicated team working in Scrum methodology. It's six people in Devante and one product owner on the team side, and we prepare process of continuous delivery. So we automate tests and we automate deployment. So after change in the system, you just push a button and code goes through automated tests through deployment procedures, and, you know, under 5 minutes the changes are online, which is great for the business persons. And of course, we are using data on a large scale to improve user experience. We are using Google Analytics and tools like this. And here's a fun example. We created a product list with six views. So we have miniatures view, we have list view, we have one column view, two columns view, and etc. etc. And after this, we analyze data, and it occurs that 97% of customers prefer one specific view, product list view of like miniatures. So you know, after this insight, we deleted other views, declutter interface. We have some free space now to experiment with other functions, but we do this kind of changes on a daily basis. And if we are talking about numbers here are quite interesting, because after the first year we have 50% of online sales. It was 50 millions euro or online revenue, and today after third year, after third quarter, we have like over hundreds of millions of euro online revenue for quarters from first to third in last year, and 67% of online sales. So the project has been a huge success for TIM. They achieved their business goals. They diversify business. They acquire a lot of new customers. Then improve business effectiveness. And Harvard Business Review has written recently an article about the project. And the project was shown as a true digital transformation. And what is most important, TIM clients really like the B2B platform. They are open to use it. So the next thing we're thinking about is improving the retention of clients through big data, and also automated pricing optimization is the next big thing we want to pursue. So if you are interested in this kind of projects, there's a great B2B e-commerce how to become successful white paper. If you want, I can just mail it to you. Just drop me an email at hi@divante.co and I will send it to you. Thank you very much.